Man, you have all kind of females, just like you have in the West, but in Japan, the women are feminine. They are feminine. You get these articles out there, like I saw it on IP's channel. Some woman wrote it. Oh, they're trying to be just like me in the West. No, they're not. They have issues with their men, just like any other country in the world. The men will be sexually harassing them in some cases. But sexual harassment is actually looked down, is frowned upon now in modern Japan. You can't just get away with it like you used to be able to get away with it. So the women are cognizant of that. They're fighting against that. But that don't mean they're trying to be like these females in the West just because they're fighting against sexual harassment. So I just want to put that out there. These women like to write these articles and like to, like if it's only 3% feminist, they might say 25% of the women in Japan are feminist. No, they're not. That's just numbers that she herself out there because she wrote the article to try to beef it up. Just like I saw this article, they're saying 10% of the population in Japan is gay. No, it's not. If they're lucky, it's like anywhere else, 4%. The average population, 4% of any population will be gay. Those are just the law of averages. So I don't know where they came up with this 10 or even 15%. That's not right. That is not true. The women are feminine, and the thing I like is, we're not with many of them from many different places in Japan. It depends on what kind of woman you like. So I'll give you an example. I lived in Osaka. Osaka is a big city. Yokohama is the second biggest city. Tokyo is the first biggest city, but I mean it's the biggest city, but Osaka is the second largest metropolis because you have Osaka, Kyoto, Kobe, Nara, Wakayama, Nishinomiya, all these major cities around that corridor. So I can get the Kobe from Osaka Umeda Station on the Hankyu line in 35 minutes. I can get to Kyoto in 40 minutes. I can get the Nara from Uehomachi Station on the Kintetsu line in 35 minutes. I can get to Wakayama in less than an hour. So there's a lot of people in that area. So the women that come from there, they have their own way of doing things, their own way that they got raised. Most of the time in those big cities, the females don't get to see their daddies as much because the daddy has to commute, long commutes back and forth to home. But where my wife is from and other areas of Japan that don't have to worry about those long commutes, meaning you can drive your car to work. Those women there are raised differently because their daddies are home by 5 or 6 o'clock at night. They're able to spend time with their daughters and their family, and therefore the daughters will pick up certain traits and traditions from looking at that traditional family of mother and father being together. My wife experienced that, so that's why she makes a good wife, because I'm not saying the ones in Tokyo don't. But I'm just saying that the women that come from those type of areas to me are better because they've seen their mother and father's relationship, especially if it's a good one, because they spend more time. Japan is all about spending time with the family. If they come from a family where the daddy's never home, they will more than likely will not be the best female to be with if you want to marry them. Hanging out is cool. They're going to be feminine, but they're also going to be looking for a masculine man and looking to reinvent themselves. A lot of women in Japan, they have low body counts. Some people be like, well, they got a high body count, man. There was a post up in IP where this brother wrote this book, the Yellow Cab book that everybody was talking about, Black Passenger Yellow Cabs. Japanese women are called yellow cabs. That name came from in Hawaii because they had a reputation of going on vacation and sleeping around because. And so people say, hey man, you can get you a yellow cab, Japanese woman, and ride them all you want. Well, that was in Hawaii, and that's the reputation they gave. That's an unfair assessment of them because they don't go there to look for that. They go there because they're not on vacation that long. They're only there for 3 or 4 days. I know because I used to date a lot of them when I was living in Hawaii. So I know that they're not there that long and they're not looking for that. A lot of times you'll meet them and you won't even get to sleep with them, you're just hanging out. So I just want to quell that notion. Also, a Japanese woman who will have a boyfriend once in a while. Well, most of them don't have boyfriends, but the ones that do, they won't see their boyfriends that much as you think. It's not like in the West where you got a girl or she got a boyfriend and every day they're hanging out or they're living together or they're sleeping all the time. In Japan, the girlfriend boyfriends mostly do not live together. She'll have her apartment in Osaka or wherever she wants to live. He'll have his apartment there. He's got work. He's busy at work. She's got work. She's busy at work. Then she got to meet her girlfriends to hang out that she hangs out with. And so oftentimes, she might not see her boyfriend for maybe every 2 weeks or once a month. And that's usually on a Sunday. So, and they don't sleep with their boyfriends much. So if you meet a Japanese girl who said, oh, yeah, I have a boyfriend, that doesn't mean she has a high body count because she doesn't. And that doesn't mean that she's engaging in sex with this guy all the time, too, because she's not. So I just want to point that out.